England is building a new fighter jet that is really advanced, named Tempest. Tempest is the sixth generation battle. The aircraft is being developed for the UK Royal Air Force as part of the FCAS program, which aims to enhance the nation's air combat capabilities in response to evolving threats. The aircraft is being developed by the Tempest team led by the UK-based Bay Systems Aerospace Company. Industrial partners on the team include Leonardo, an Italian aerospace company, MBDA UK, a European missile division, systems provider MBDA, and Rolls-Royce. The Tempest FCAS aircraft is part of the UK's combat air strategy, which was officially formalized in July 2018. The Ministry of Defence awarded the Bay System a contract with a value of around £250 million, or about $347 million, for the design and development of the Tempest FCAS aircraft. In July 2021, the FCAS Tempest aircraft concept and assessment stage project began. The FCAS Tempest aircraft are expected to enter service with the Royal Air Force in 2035. The Tempest will be an optional sixth-generation manned stealth fighter designed to be interfaced, flexible, and upgradable to keep up with changing threats. The design is expected to include an open architecture to allow future adaptations and capability upgrades. To operate at higher airframe temperatures, the will be made of advanced composite materials and additives. The aircraft will be capable of scalable autonomy, allowing for unmanned, manned, and optional manned operations. The aircraft will have a defensive assistance system that can track targets and intercept incoming missiles. It will be able to support existing plans and future weapons such as the Meteor, the next generation that goes beyond the visual range of air-to-air missiles, using artificial intelligence and machine learning. The enhanced software will control the weapon effects management system, coordinating all weapons on the battlefield. In stealth mode, the aircraft will be able to completely dominate the battlefield while carrying a significant payload, including next-generation weapons such as directed energy and hypersonic missiles. The fighter will act as a node in a network of systems spanning all battlespace domains. In future conflicts, the aircraft will operate in tandem with other FCAS systems, such as civilian unmanned combat aircraft platforms, satellites, and cybersecurity centers, to provide unmanned and manned aviation capabilities. The aircraft will use machine learning, artificial intelligence, and autonomous systems. In addition, it is expected to control drones using swarming technology, which will aggregate data from multiple sources to generate reliable information that can be shared with other connected aircraft in the combat cloud. Rolls-Royce created a new turbine engine demonstrator called the Orpheus for the FCAS program. The advanced power and propulsion system will be aerodynamically designed to optimize overall performance, including range and payload capability. The aircraft will be supported by an efficient power system with intelligent power and an efficient thermal management system to reduce the aircraft's thermal signature. The aircraft will be equipped with state-of-the-art sensors enabling secure and robust exchange of information on the battlefield via combat clouds. Effectors built into the aircraft will allow interaction with a variety of non-kinetic effectors, such as electronic warfare jamming and directed energy weapons. These effectors will assist in the assessment and evaluation of incoming threats, as well as management of deployments and appropriate methods to defeat them. The cockpit of the Tempest system will be adaptable to the pilot's attire. A head-mounted display helmet based on the next-generation wearable cockpit technology concept. Plus, in virtual reality, interactive cockpit display and controls will be projected directly in front of the pilot's eyes using a helmet. Other ideas, such as virtual assistants for pilot assistants, are also being tested. More information about the United Kingdom's Next Generation Air Combat Program has emerged with the recent announcement that a demonstrator aircraft will fly in the next 5 years. The Bay Systems' leading work on the program also presents a new model of a potential Tempest configuration, suggesting a manned fighter that overall resembles the United States F-22 Raptor, a stealth fighter, while its empennage resembles that of Northrop's F-22S competitor, the YF-23. More information about the United Kingdom's Next Generation Air Combat Program has emerged with the recent announcement that a demonstrator aircraft will fly in the next 5 years. The Bay System's leading work on the program also presents a new model of a potential Tempest configuration, suggesting a manned fighter that overall resembles the United States F-22 Raptor, a stealth fighter, while its empennage resembles that of Northrop's F-22S competitor, the YF-23. The latest Tempest concept retains the overall hidden configuration and mid to large sizes of the previous one. Significant changes have been made to the shape of the wing plan, with the Lambda wing being replaced by a truncated Delta with an arrow-like trailing edge. The engine intakes, as well as the overall forward airframe profile, now appear to have more in common with the F-22 than the previous iteration, featuring the Pelican's distinctive nose profile. The tail surfaces still rudder vitters, as on the YF-23 rather than separate vertical stabilizers and stabilizers, but they are now larger and mounted immediately after the trailing edge of the wing. The engine nozzles appear to be tightly closed at the rear of the fuselage, and the zinc previously seen between them has disappeared. Tempest capabilities appear to be convincing, at least on paper, though they may lack once the aircraft enters service. After all, the current timeline looks very ambitious if, as previously stated, a demonstrator starts flying in the next 5 years. The time between its first flight and the planned initial operational capability for a representative production Tempest could be as little as 8 years. In comparison, the Typhoon took 17 years between the demonstrator's first flight and service entry. Advances in design and engineering should help close the gap. The fact is that economic reality is coupled with the unpredictable nature of non-virtuals. The job tests tend to present the same types of challenges as they have in previous fighter programs. Further, for the program to be successful, it must make a credible case that it provides significant economic benefits and that the money would not be better spent on restocking the F-35B fleet, investing in unmanned systems, or some of these big-ticket defense programs. Others compete for scarce funds.